Alopecia is the medical term for hair loss, and this encompasses any type of hair loss, whether it be temporary or more permanent. There's more than 20 types of alopecia, and they can broadly be divided into those that cause scarring and those that are non-scarring. The most common type which affects men is male pattern hair loss, and the female equivalence tends to be female pattern hair loss, which develops much more slowly. There are other types of hair loss which are not hormone or genetic dependent, and these include those that are autoimmune, such as alopecia areata, which is another very common cause of hair loss. There can also be alterations in the hair cycle, and telogen effluvium or chronic telogen effluvium causes excess hair shedding, which can cause thinning and a reduction in the volume of the hair. The presentation of alopecia is very much dependent on the cause. So the commonest cause of hair loss in men is male pattern hair loss, and that tends to present in men in their 20s or 30s. Usually they notice recession of the hair over the temples. They may also notice thinning over the crown of the scalp. In women, the commonest cause is female pattern hair loss, and often women notice thinning of the hair at the top of the scalp compared to the hair at the back of the scalp. Both these conditions, that is male pattern hair loss and female pattern hair loss, have a strong genetic component. However, male pattern hair loss tends to be more strongly influenced by hormonal factors. Other causes of hair loss include autoimmune type of hair loss, and the commonest of this is alopecia areata. In alopecia areata, patients often notice or are incidentally told they have a single discrete patch of hair loss, which is often a patch of bald scalp. In terms of scarring hair loss, patients often get symptoms as compared to patients with non-scarring types of hair loss. This can include a stinging sensation, a sensation of burning or discomfort, and patients may also experience tenderness on touching the scalp. Looking at the scalp, there may be changes such as redness around the hair follicle, or indeed larger areas of redness, and often over time, if left untreated, these can progress to a scarring patch of hair loss where a scar is seen on the scalp. So the treatment for alopecia is very dependent upon the underlying cause and the diagnosis. Male pattern hair loss, minoxidil is often a good treatment, and tablet options include finasteride. Women have a few more options for female pattern hair loss. Again, minoxidil can be used with good effect. Additionally, hormonal therapies such as the oral contraceptive pill or hormone replacement therapies can be useful. However, it's important to be aware that some are hair friendly and some may encourage hair loss. Patients with alopecia areata, it's important to treat the underlying autoimmune cause. This may be with steroid tablets, steroid creams, or non-steroid based creams. Alternatives include light therapy, immunotherapy, and tablet treatments that suppress the overall immune system. There are some newer therapies that are in trial which look very promising. Treatment of telogen effluvium is looking at the underlying cause, identifying it and then addressing it, and there are a huge number of lifestyle factors that one would consider. In terms of scarring hair loss, the aim of treatment is to reduce the inflammation to prevent the scarring from occurring. Therefore, early treatment is important. A variety of creams, lotions, and foams may be used on the surface of the scalp, but often tablets that suppress the immune system are needed. As with all treatments, and especially so in hair loss, it's important to balance the risk and the benefits.